Oh hey, we are great O-type stars. No doubt we are the hottest and most massive stars, temperatures exceeding 30,000 degrees.
Hold on. But I'm not massive.
Who are you?
Sorry. I'm a sub-dwarf.
And anyway, most of us are the most massive stars in the universe, okay? Imagine a stellar ballet where O-type stars gracefully waltz through the vastness of space, leaving a dazzling legacy. Aha!
Don't be that awkward, okay? I don't know what to say next in this situation.
Hey, don't leave that early. Introduce yourself first.
Heh. Moving on to the B-type stars. Now we encounter the brilliant blue gems of the cosmic canvas. Of course, we are a lot less brighter and hotter than O-type stars. But we are still stronger than 98% of the stars in the universe. So please, respect us. I had a bro called Sirius B, but it dropped out years ago and became a white dwarf sadly. Anyway, with temperatures ranging from 10,000 to 30,000 degrees, we radiate a sapphire glow. We are the celestial artists, painting the cosmos with our mesmerizing hues.
Wow! Oh, look. Isn't that awkward too?
Hey, let's not tear each other down, okay? At least we both glow blue and together represent the most energetic stars in the universe. By the way, you won't even find us in aging elliptical galaxies because... They're not cool enough.
Woo. Is it safe for me to speak? Oh, okay. We are what? We are A-type stars. The pure white's color in the night sky is our spectral identity. We are not dangerous as those BNOs. They pretty much don't exist in aging galaxies is just because they don't lay to Ethi of long. Like, O-type stars usually explode themselves in under 10 million years, and B-type stars die down in no longer than a few hundred million years. But we A-type stars live for a billion or two. That's the difference. And please do not look down on us. We still surpass 93% of the stars in the universe in terms of mass. At around 7,500 to 10,000 degrees, stars like Fomalhaut and Vega belong to our A-type family in the present. We are half as wide as B-type stars, though 10 to 20 times brighter than Sun. I think we are the best in balancing strength and longevity. Lolololololololol.
OBA. It's F's time. We F-type stars live for up to 5 billion years. And most importantly, we are capable for holding exoplanets for enough time to develop life, while OBAs just blow themselves up.
What F-type stars don't tell you is that...
Shut the hell.
Their average radius is some 3/4 of us A-type stars, and... only 2 to 7 times as luminous as the Sun.
Duh. But we all looked white. We F-type stars are ranging from 6,000 to 7,600 degrees, and we actually look whiter than A-type stars. But sure, we have a pretty low presence. Except Procyon.
Well?
What's going on?
Do you need technical support?
Oh, nothing. This is G-type star. Well, first, most of you, bigger, brighter, hotter stars. In some point of your life, you will become a member of us. Second, when it comes to main sequence stars, O-type live for 5 million years, A-type live for a billion years, we G-type live for 10 billion years. This is not something you big stars can achieve. Third, we hold the most popularity. The Sun. Fourth, our temperature, between 5,300 and 6,000 degrees. That gives us a unique yellow color. Finally, lots and lots of planets to love. Okay, bye-bye.
You guys are too powerful. But I'm only immersed in my small world of faint energy. Hint hint, find the warm, orange glow that defines our spectral presence in the galaxy. With temperatures between 3,900 and 5,300 Kelvin, we just exude a cozy radiance, fostering the potential for habitable zones and planetary companions. Plus, we are not too bad after all. Not to mention those red giants within our spectrum. Just put main sequence stars into perspective. We are still more massive than 68% of stars in the universe, above the average line. And our great lifespan, up to 75 billion years. We can sit back and watch 1,000 lifetimes of B-type stars.
Another reality is that any one of us can outshine hundreds to hundreds of thousands of you as a main sequence star. And you guys as main sequence stars are like some 60% to 90% the mass of the sun. About 10 to 20% of us.
Huh. Our representative stars include Pollux.
Hey yo, finally us M-type stars. You encounter the cool, red embers that mark our cosmic identity. With temperatures below 3,900 Kelvin, we have a louder name, Red Dwarfs. We embrace the tranquility of the celestial night, painting the universe in shades of crimson. The quantity of M-type stars is undoubtedly the most in the universe, even you add what K, G, F, A, B, O together, it's still less than M's. And don't fall into the trap that M-type stars equals what? Proxima Centauri, TRAPPIST, 1, no. It equals Betelgeuse, UI Scuti, Stevenson, 218. Okay?
We have nothing to argue.
But don't look down on Proxima and TRAPPIST, 1, they live for 5 to 10 trillion years. Probably 1 million times longer than many O-type stars. LOL.
Well, this is getting complicated.
Hey, do not cheat. You too?
All right.
I'm back.
What was that?
Let's dance.
Well, I think it is unfair.
No, it is extremely fair.
Everyone.
Who's that?
What?
Nothing big, just consider us, maybe?
Okay.